Hi friends, Megan from Figma here with three new updates to frames in Figma. So let's go. The first update is for those designers who always position their first frame on their Figma canvas at 0, 0. Previously in Figma, when you created a new frame and placed it onto an empty canvas, its position will be determined by wherever you are on the canvas. Not anymore. Now, in UI 3, when adding a new frame to an empty canvas, it will always place that frame at origin point 0, 0. If I delete this frame, I press the F key over here, I can choose another frame and it will currently be positioned at 0, 0. It's a quality update that'll help keep your files nice and tidy. The next update is all about creating additional frames in Figma. You can see that I have this iPhone 16 frame on my canvas. Now, when I enable the frame tool by pressing F and I click to create a new frame, it will remember the dimensions of the most recent frame that I have here. If I create another frame by pressing F and I draw out a wide frame, when I press F again and click, you will see that it matches the dimensions of the most recent frame that I have there. The way that this worked previously is if I created a frame, then pressed F and click, it would generate a frame that is 100 by 100, which is less than ideal. So the new behavior is much nicer. And now for the third and my favorite update. When pressing the F key and hovering over any existing frame, you'll notice some new buttons that will allow you to duplicate and create additional frames. Let's say here I've pasted in a design and it is part of a series and I want to duplicate this design to continue to riff on it. When I press the F key and I hover over this frame, you'll see these little plus symbols here that will allow me to duplicate that frame and in addition will move over other frames as part of that series. Now press the F key, I hover over here and I want to generate a blank frame in between these two frames. Hold down the Option key or the Alt key on Windows. When I click, it will generate a blank frame. Okay, to quickly recap all of the features. First off, using the frame tool, any new frame on a blank canvas will always be at 0, 0. Next, when using the frame tool and clicking on the canvas, it will remember your previous frame. And last, when you press F and hover over a frame, you will see UI that gives you the ability to then duplicate frames that you have. And if you have a frame that has content in it, yet you want to generate a blank frame, when you press the F key, hold down the Option or the Alt key on Windows, click, and it will generate a blank frame. Hopefully you found that helpful. That's it for today's updates. All of these updates are exclusive to Figma's redesigned UI 3. If you want these new frame behaviors, be sure to upgrade to UI 3. I hope you enjoy these updates, and as always, happy designing.